Hare Krishna. So a warm welcome to all the devotees who have joined today for our continued discussion on the 18th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita as it is. As I mentioned on the message that I sent today afternoon and then in the remainder in the evening, this section of the Gita, 18.64 to 66, is labeled as the most confidential knowledge. And Srila Prabhupada calls it the most important, section of the Gita. These verses are very, very important. They're quoted again and again by Srila Prabhupada, by his followers, by all the devotees within ISKCON. And many people outside also quote these verses. They're very, very important. So we will try to just read the 64 and 65. 66 we will do next time. So verse number 64. Sarva guhyatamam bhuyaha shrinu me paramam vachaha ishtosi me dridam iti tato vakshyami hete hitam. Because you are my very dear friend, I am speaking to you my supreme instruction, the most confidential knowledge of all. Hear this from me, for it is for your benefit. And in 65, Krishna says, always think of me, man mana, bhava mad bhakto, become my devotee, mad yaji, worship me, ma namaskaru, offer your homage unto me. Thus you will come to me without fail. Maam evaishasi. Okay, maam evaishasi. Satyamte, I promise you this, prati jane, priyosi me, because you are my very dear friend. So, last time we were discussing, if you remember, the last few verses of the Bhagavad Gita that we have been discussing, we started with 18.48 to 55. We said this is confidential knowledge, which is the knowledge about the Brahman, about the impersonal Brahman, which is everywhere. Then we discussed, Krishna says, okay, now I'm going to tell you more confidential knowledge. So more confidential knowledge is the knowledge about the super soul. So again, Krishna speaks. Last time we were discussing 18.61 to 63, where Krishna speaks about the super soul. And then he ends the Gita. He ends. He says that surrender to the super soul, because he is the source of everything. Please surrender. And then in one sense, again, the Bhagavad Gita is over, right? But yet again, now after saying everything is over, he again starts again in 64, 65. He again speaks. And a few more verses, another 8-10 verses Krishna speaks, and then it actually ends, right? So this time, what we're going to discuss, 18.64 to 66, we'll do it in two parts because it's not possible to complete this in one go. There's a lot to be spoken. I'm not qualified at all to speak about surrender. But since I'm in this, in this position, I have this service. Therefore, I'm trying to speak about this. So this time, the most confident. So he's spoken about confidential. He's spoken about more confidential. And this section, Krishna himself says, guhyatamam. Matlab, the most confidential. This is the most confidential knowledge. The ultimate and concluding instructions of the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna gives in 65 and 66. They are like the samam bonam, the end of everything. Sab kuch bol ke hone ke baad, ant mein Bhagwan hame ye seekh dete hain. This is the takeaway message of the Bhagavad Gita. Matlab, we have like we discussed few weeks back, we completed 10 years of this program somewhere around October 24th, right? I completed. Program is 20 years old, but more than 20 years old. But I started coming somewhere around 2010 October. I completed 10 years. So for 10 years, we have been going through verse by verse the Bhagavad Gita. And now we have come to the absolute conclusion. In one sense, if you have missed all 10 years, ek bhi lecture attend nahi kiya, or you attended, but you did not understand anything, or you attended, you fell asleep, or you never paid, you never paid your faith, you never invested your faith in these instructions, doesn't matter, no problem, right? Because if these two verses somehow, and it can't happen without the grace of the Lord, without the grace of the devotees, it is not possible for us to understand anything in Bhagavad Gita, right? Even Arjuna, initially Krishna tried to tell him, what is this miserly weakness that has come upon you? What are you doing? Stand up and fight. Those words did not appeal to Arjuna. He could not understand. He needed to become completely bewildered, completely depressed, completely in anxiety, completely in confusion. Then he surrendered to Krishna. And then after that, Krishna starts speaking to him, the Bhagavad Gita. So sometimes, we have to understand that opportunities may be lost, but sometimes opportunities come back. So if we have lost the opportunity over so many years, we have not really heard the Gita, we have not really taken shelter, here is the opportunity. Because in these two, three verses, Krishna is going to once more give you the essence of everything that he has spoken. 700 verses, uska saar abhi aane wala hai. It's going to come now, right? So this, after providing confidential knowledge about the Brahman, more confidential about Paramatma, now Krishna gives the most confidential knowledge, the ultimate and concluding instruction of the Gita, which is what? Become a pure devotee of Krishna. Become a devotee. This is the ultimate instruction of the Gita. It is not about dharma. It is not about artha. It is not about doing your duty. It is not about anything else. Ultimately, this is what Krishna wants from Arjuna. And this is what he wants from you and me also. He's not saying this only to Arjuna. This is for us as well, right? We have to become a pure devotee of Krishna. So the most essential confidential knowledge is what? That which tells us, just surrender to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Not Brahman, not Paramatma. Surrender to Krishna, the person Krishna. Prabhupada makes it very clear in the purport of 18.65. He tells what way, what form of Krishna you have to surrender. Neither, nor other. Ekdam clear. Because aapne baki kuch suna nahi suna. Ye suno, ye bahut important. Right? Like that. So Prabhupada makes it very clear. He doesn't compromise. So it's the most essential part of knowledge. Whatever knowledge we may have acquired in this world, whether it is through our schools, through our college, through our family, parents, friends, uncles, aunties, cousins, colleagues, teachers, professors, whatever knowledge we may have acquired in this world, right? That knowledge is at best kind of useful because usse hum log apna, maybe hum log ka pet bhar sakte, right? We can somehow keep body and soul together with that knowledge. But the most essential part of all knowledge is what? That one must surrender to the Supreme Lord. Surrender to Krishna. And this is not to be carried out just by Arjuna, but by all living entities. So we can just see, last time also we discussed that Krishna had already finished the Bhagavad Gita in 18.63. He says, now I have finished telling you everything. Bhai, aapko jo bhi bolna tha, sab bol diya. I've told you everything. Now, deliberate fully on what I have told you and then yad ichchasi tatha kuru. I have given you all instructions. Now you deliberate on that. Socho. Main koi force nahi kar raha. The Supreme Lord is giving that ultimate choice of what you want after giving all instructions. We discussed last time. Logical, emotional, spiritual, philosophical. Sare angle se Bhagwan ne Arjun ko samjaya. He has explained everything to him. And then after everything, he leaves a choice to him. He doesn't say, okay, I've told you now, just do it. No, he gives him a choice. He says, do what you want to. Right? So now, he has asked Arjuna to deliberate and do what he wants. So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, one of the acharyas in our parampara, he comments that Krishna probably saw Arjuna now deliberating. Achha, itna sab bataya hai. Okay, now I must decide what I need to do. So out of his unlimited compassion, we have discussed many times that Bhagavad Gita is not a dry philosophical scripture. It is a samvad. It is a conversation that is happening between two very, very close friends. Arjuna and Krishna are their relatives also, and they're very close friends. They are willing to give up their lives for each other. Utna close friends. They're very, very close. Krishna has given his sister also to Arjuna, Subhadra. Subhadra is the wife of Arjuna. So in so many ways, Krishna is connected to Arjuna. He's very, very dear to him. So therefore, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says, when Krishna sees, you know, Arjuna deliberating silently, achha, abhi kya karna chahiye? What should I do? He says, achha, Baba, you stop worrying. You stop thinking about what I should do, kya, what, which instruction is important, what did Krishna mean by this. Leave it. I will now again speak to you the essence of this entire Shastra. This entire Gita that I have spoken to you, I will tell you the essence. Bhuyaha. Bhuyaha means again. Right? In this 64th verse, Krishna says, he says, Sarva Guhyatamam Bhuyaha. Meaning again, the most confidential knowledge. Shrinu me paramam vacha. Now listen to this, the most confidential, most ultimate. Paramam means supreme. Maine tumko bahut sare instructions diye. I have told you a lot of things, Arjuna. But now, Shrinu, listen to this. This is the most confidential and this is the most supreme of all the instructions that I have given you so far. Okay? Just don't exert yourself. Jada fight mat maro. Main abhi tumko just essence mein bata raha hu, right? So Krishna, why he uses this word bhuyaha, meaning again. So Srila Prabhupada asks and the acharyas ask that why is this manmanabhava, this verse repeated? In the entire Gita, this is the only couplet which is repeated. Manmanabhava mat bhakto madhyaji naam namaskuru. This four instructions that Krishna gives, he is given in the 9th chapter also. And he gives it again over here. So the Bhurijan Prabhu explains that this is being done to stress what is the essence of the Gita. The scripture and the instructions of the Lord are actually crystal clear. They're actually crystal clear. But they're clear when they come through the via medium of the acharyas. When the acharyas explain, because if I go and I try to read the Gita with my limited 450 grams of brain matter, how much I will understand? What I will be able to make out? It is like if I walk into, you know, some grand temple in South India, what I will be able to appreciate? Oh, achha, okay, there is this column here, there are some 500 figurines here. And here there is some different architecture. There is a, you know, big dome they have made. What I will understand? Nothing. But if a person, acharya, who is living in that temple, who knows the whole history, geography of the temple, he explains, suddenly everything, it jumps out. You know, the architecture jumps out of the, you know, the carvings jump out at you. The deities will, you know, suddenly come alive. Because the Dham Vasi reveals the Dham to us, right? So this knowledge of Gita, you know, is so confidential. It may be available. Like I go to this temple, I see the deities, but mujhe kuch samajh mein nahi aata. I don't understand anything. It remains confidential. The deities, the pastimes of the deities, how those deities appeared there, how did this temple come up, it's all confidential. But when the Dhamvasi reveals to us, then that knowledge becomes. That's why most confidential knowledge, when we say, kya confidential, yaar? It is Bhagavad Gita. You guys are yourself saying that some 60 crore Bhagavad Gita, 60 crores, okay, since Bhagavad Gita as it is was released way back in 1971 or 72, 60 crore, okay, 60 crore Bhagavad Gita have been distributed all over the world in so many different languages. So what is confidential? Iske baad kya confidential? Sabko to pata hai. That is what is confidential. That unless the Lord decides to reveal it to us, we will never understand the essence. We may read these verses, we may memorize them. There are many children who memorize 15 chapter, 12 chapter. Ask them to repeat the verses. Even 10, 20 years later, they may be able to remember the verses. But have they understood the essence? Have they got what Krishna is saying? Are they living by it? That's what it is. Most confidential one. Therefore, the 9th chapter, because of this verse being there, Manmanabhava, because this verse is there in the 9th chapter, therefore, Acharya has explained, therefore, the 9th chapter is entitled Most Confidential Knowledge. Right? So, who can understand this confidential knowledge? Who can understand that this is the essence of the Gita? So, Krishna himself says in 64th verse, that one who is dear to me, he is saying that you are dear to me, therefore you can understand. A common man cannot understand this, right? In 64th verse as well as 65th verse, both the verses, Krishna refers to Arjuna as his dear friend. In 64th verse, he says Ishta, meaning dear, right? And in 65, he says Priyosime, again, dear to me. So because Arjuna is dear to him, therefore Krishna is telling him also, and he can understand also. Otherwise, commonly, if just imagine if a great man comes to you and says, always think of me, become my slave, become my devotee, worship me, offer your obeisances unto me. Kone bhai, who are you? Why should I do all this? Right? That is how we think. We are not able to appreciate if someone comes and tells that to us. Same way, if Krishna is saying this, it is declared all over the Gita and all over the scripture that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the source of Brahman. He is the source of Paramatma. He is the source of everything, material and spiritual worlds. Everything emanates from him. It is stated in multiple places in the Gita. So then with that knowledge, if Krishna says that, okay, man mana, think of me, bhava mad bhakto, become my devotee, one may feel that, oh, people should be able to accept this. But no, it's not so easy. It's not so easy. So this very, very confidential knowledge that Krishna is giving in the Bhagavad Gita, while it is available to everybody, but still people don't see. Pashyan api na pashyati. They're able to see, but they are not able to see. You know, it is unless someone brings it into your sight, you can't see it. Right? So that's how it works. So, in the 65th verse, okay, we'll read the translation again since it's very important. Once more, we'll read the verse and the translation, okay. Manmana bhava madbhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mame vaishasi satyamte prati jane priyosime. Always think of me, become my devotee, worship me, and offer your homage unto me. Thus, you will come to me without fail. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend. So, in several places in the Gita, Krishna is making different kinds of assurances. In the 4th chapter itself, he has said that janma karma cha me divyam evam yo vetti tattvataha tyaktva deham punar janma naiti. Maameti so Arjuna. So there he has said that if you just understand that my birth and my activities in this material world are transcendental, don't try to apply your material logic, material equations, material formulas to it. It's transcendental. One who simply understands this in essence. Tyaktva deham punar janma naiti. After giving up the body, there is no further, you know, no further life, you will not be born again. Maam eti so Arjuna, comes back to me. Here he has mentioned. Then in 8th chapter, he said that antakale cha maam eva smaran mukva kalevaram ya prayati sammad bhavam yati asti na atra sanshaya. He says, one who remembers me alone at the time of death, such a person will certainly return to me. Of this, there is no doubt. That means, apne man mein shak mat rakho, shanka mat rakho, don't be doubtful. These are the words not coming from some aira gaira. It is coming from the Supreme Lord himself. He is assuring, just remember me at the time of death and you will come to me without fail. Meaning you will be liberated from cycle of birth and death. Right? Now the second time he said, there are other times also, but I'll just refer to these three instances where Krishna is saying. And now for the third time over here, Krishna is saying, always think of me, become my devotee, worship me and offer your homage unto me. Thus you will come to me without fail. Again, without fail, without doubt. Don't have any doubt in your mind. And Krishna is again uske upar is saying, I promise you this. Ye mera vachan hai, satyam te. Satyam. Satyam means commitment. I am giving you a commitment. I promise. Pratijane. Pratijane has used earlier also. That, what is that? He says that, Kaunteya pratijani hi, name bhaktya pranishati. Declare it boldly to the world, Arjuna. My devotee shall never perish. So many beautiful things, declarations that Krishna has made in the Gita. But this one and the very next one are the two most important declarations, right? And this verse specifically is called the essence of the Gita, right? So, what is Krishna saying? The most confidential part of knowledge is that one should become a pure devotee of Krishna and always think of him and act for him. This is really the goal of human life. This is the goal of human life. You know, in all our life, throughout our life, we have been running after so many different goals. Some of us don't have goals. Many people are simply without any goal, just floating the way, matlab, aaj subah hawa east se west chali, to wo east se west mein float honge. Aaj hawa north se south chali, so wo log north se south float honge. There are many people who are like that, who just live by circumstances. Their only goal in life is to live by circumstances. They have no goals. They have no aspirations. They have nothing, right? And then there is a class of people who have goals, who have aspirations. And what are their goals? Most people have goals like, I want to be rich. I want to have at least, I want to be a millionaire before I die. I want to visit so-and-so places before I die. Bucket list. We call it the bucket list. Marne ke pehle ye ye karne ka hai bhai apne ko. I want to have so much bank balance. I want to have so much corpus, you know, money saved up for my future, for my children's education, for their wedding, for my own retirement. Yaar, retirement ke baad na shaan se jiyenge, maze karenge, you know, I'll enjoy my life. So everyone has, not everyone, but a lot of people have goals. But we need to understand that while these goals are important, I'm not minimizing them for a moment. I'm not saying that, oh, you should not have any goals. No, these are all materialistic goals. Yeah, these goals are needed. Because if, like today morning only, His Grace Gaurang Prabhu in the Bhagavatam class was saying, if you don't have a goal, tum karoge kya? What you will do? What are you running towards? Like if somebody asks you that, where are you going? Pata nahi. Kyu ja rahe ho? Pata nahi. I don't know. What is the goal of your life? I don't know. It sounds very stupid, doesn't it? If someone asks you what is the goal of your life, you say, I don't know. You don't know means what? You should have been some goal. No, I really don't know. I just, you know, live by the moment. Mere saamne thali ka plate aata hai, main khata hun usme se. Bas yaar, you know, college jata hun, college mein lecture attend karta hun. I attend lectures. I appear for exam. I don't need goal or anything. I don't trouble myself. Someone who talks like this is considered a fool. So we must have goals. There's nothing wrong in having a goal. But what is the ultimate goal of life? What goal distinguishes you from that cheetah which is running in the Sahara desert बिहाइंड अ गजल, बिहाइंड अ डियर, उस चीता का भी गोल है, उसका भी गोल है कि मुझे ये डियर को पकड़ना है. आई हैव टू कैच दिस डियर, इट हैज अ गोल. आई हैव टू कैच अ डियर एवरी 3 days सो दैट आई एंड माई फैमिली कैन सर्वाइव. दे ऑल्सो हैव गोल्स, दे मे नॉट हैव सच लॉन्ग टर्म गोल्स बिकॉज दे आर नॉट दैट इंटेलिजेंट, बट या देर आर मेनी स्पीशीज ऑफ यू नो ऑफ लाइफ दैट आर वेरी इंटेलिजेंट, दे हैव लॉन्ग टर्म गोल्स. द बीज, the bees keep collecting honey long term. Very often they don't even live to enjoy what they have done, right? So just having goals is not important. What is the ultimate goal of life? Ultimate, if all these material goals are met, sab ho gaya aapka goal, to aapke jeevan ka lakshya kya hai? If I take away everything else, what is the goal of life? This is the goal of life. This verse and the result that comes from living this verse is really the goal of life. What is that? The goal of life is to develop uninterrupted, unmotivated love for God. Not for your wife, not for your husband, not for your children, not for your parents, not for your community, not for your country, not for humanity, but for the Supreme Lord Krishna. Savai pumsam paro dharmo yato bhaktir adokshite ahaituki apratiyata yayatma suprasidati. This is the ultimate goal of life, to develop love for God, right? And why? Because if we love God, then everything else is included in that. Because He is the root. Krishna is the root. And everything else are the trunk and the trees, branches and the leaves and the flowers and the fruits. Everything else in the material world is that. If we simply please the root, then everything else will automatically become pleased. If we develop love for Krishna, automatically we will love our family, we will love our neighbors, we will love our community, we will love our country, we will love the whole world, because we will be able to see Krishna in everyone. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane kavi hastini suni cheva swapakecha pandita samadarshina. One who is samadarshi, who sees that the same spirit soul which is part and parcel of Krishna is residing in everyone's heart, how can that person not love everyone? That person loves everyone because he can see Krishna in everybody, right? So this is really the goal of human life. All other goals are subsidiary, subservient to this one goal. So we have to make this our topmost priority in life. You may have so many other priorities. अरे नहीं, बट प्रभु जी मेरे को टाइम नहीं है. आई डोंट हैव टाइम टू चांट, आई डोंट हैव टाइम टू रीड भागवतम, आई डोंट हैव टाइम टू अटेंड दिस सत्संग आल्सो समहाउ, यू नो, वंस इन अ वे व्हेनेवर आई गेट टाइम आई कम. बाबा, वंडरफुल, वेरी नाइस. इफ यू आर समहाउ मेकिंग दिस अ प्रायोरिटी इन योर लाइफ एंड यू आर कमिंग फॉर दिस सत्संग वंस इन अ वे आल्सो, लाइक आई सेड, इफ यू आर नॉट कमिंग 10 इयर्स एंड यू हैव कम टुडे, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू यू, वंडरफुल, यू हैव कम टू द राइट प्लेस एट द राइट टाइम, राइट? बट we have to make this the goal of our life. We have to make this a priority, right? And then what does Krishna say? One who practices these four things, what are those four things? Manmana, always think of me. Bhava mad bhakto, become my devotee. Mad yaji, worship me. Mam namaskuru, pay homage or obeisances unto me. You do these four things, then what happens? Krishna gives a result of practicing these four things. You will come to me, meaning you will be liberated from the cycle of birth and death. You will come back to me in the spiritual world, and I will become yours. I will be yours. We already belong to Krishna, but Krishna doesn't belong to us. But if we are living this life then Krishna becomes our property. That is why bhakti is so rare. That's why it is not available to every Tom, Dick and Harry. जिसको चाहिए अरे भक्ति करेंगे, इतना आसान नहीं है. Looks like it is very easy. It's very simple. Bhakti is very simple to follow. What is it? Chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Read a little philosophy. Hear some nice Harikatha. Honor some nice prasad. Bring beautiful deities. Serve them. Kya badi baat hai isme? What's the big deal? Very simple, but not easy. To retain that enthusiasm, retain that fervor, to retain that determination that I will do this come what may. Whatever happens, I will not stop this. That's what again, Gauranga Prabhu, today morning's Bhagavatam class, those who haven't heard it, please hear it. Beautiful class. He speaks about commitment. He speaks about determination. How these are so important in our devotional life. Please hear it. So, we have to be determined, right? And if we are determined and we stay on this path of bhakti, as per what activities Krishna has told, which is the essence of the Gita, then what happens? We will go back to Godhead and Krishna will be ours. Bhagwan hamare ho gaye. Then after that, he gives himself up to us. That's why bhakti is so rare. Then Prabhupada in the purport, he says that always think of me does not mean that we have to become an official meditator. Hamein dhyan yoga mein nahi jana hai. Always think of me does not mean that, oh, sit down in that, Padmasan pose, go to the forest, withdraw all your senses, sit in Padmasan on the kusha grass, hold your breath, control your breathing, control all your prana, and then meditate on Krishna. No. Prabhupada is straight off the cuff. He's saying, do not think you are to become an official meditator, because Krishna is saying, think of me does not mean, always think of me does not mean becoming a meditator. Then how to think of Krishna? Man mana, engage your mind in Krishna. How can one do that? How to think of him, right? So Srila Prabhupada uses some very beautiful words. I'm just going to repeat those words. He says, mold your life, okay? Such that you will always have a chance to think of Krishna. What is the meaning of mold your life, right? Hamare paas ye jeevan jo hai, this life that we have, it is like this clay, this clay, jo bachche log jo clay se khelte hain, ya the clay that the potter uses to make pots, to make, crockery and so on and so forth. That clay is nice and soft in our hands. We can mold it the way we want to. You may say, no. But Prabhuji, now you are contradicting yourself. You always say that as per our karma, as per our desire, we are given... we are given certain set of circumstances, and with those circumstances, we are practically forced to do mold of material nature and acting upon us as per our nature. We'll be forced to act in a particular way. All that is true. Then remember the verse we discussed last time, 63. Krishna may create all kinds of trying, testing circumstances for you. Or he may create wonderful, favorable, ekdam hawa jaisa jindagi ja raha hai. He may create anything for you, any circumstance he may create for you. However, how we respond to that circumstance is always our choice. It is always in our hands. The modes of material nature will be acting in a particular way. Dekho, sense object aaya, karo maja. Modes of material nature will force you to act in a particular way. Will push you in a particular direction, will pull you in a particular direction. But you can still choose. No. Sorry, I'm not going. I have always given in. Today nahi hoga. Aaj nahi hoga. Main hamesha weak ho jata hu. Main hamesha galat kaam kar baithta hu. Kabhi mere senses pe mera koi kabu nahi. I have no control over myself. The moment that temptation comes, अरे बाबा रे, I just forget everything and I just give in. But not today. Today, I will exercise my choice and I will say no, right? That choice is always before us. So therefore, how we create our environment, our circumstances, we can't choose. But our consciousness, we can certainly choose. Our physical environment may be, we may be very unfortunate. We may not be very well off. We may be very poor. But how I create my physical environment, do I make it Krishna conscious? Do I make my environment like a temple? Or do I make my environment like, you know, some American kid's house? Wo to mere haath mein hai. That is in my choice. I can choose what I surround myself with, right? So Prabhupada is saying, mold your life such that you will always have a chance to think of Krishna. So he says, act in such a way that all your daily activities are in connection with Krishna so that you cannot but think of Krishna. Ye hamare haath mein hai. Like, you know, for example, when you were in school, many of you, some of you might identify with this. You might have had some sports star or some film actor or film actress whom you were extremely inspired by. They are like your idol. They are like your, oh my God, my star. You know, you're like completely, absolutely, you know, what is the word? Infatuated with that person. What do? We put up posters of this person all over the house. In those days, there was no Instagram, no Facebook, no Snapchat, no what else is there, whatever else is there. None of these things were there. So it was all physical. We would put up big posters all over the room, plastered with posters of these people. Why? So that sube utho, to mujhe nazar aana chahiye Michael Jackson. Ah, you know, and I should get up. And as soon as I get up, I want to put my earphones and I want to hear Michael Jackson's songs. Arey yaar, kya gaata hai, kya dance karta hai ye vyakti. Wow, amazing, right? So we surround ourselves with him. We keep reading about that person. We keep visiting the blogs of that person. We keep visiting articles about that person. We collect, we make a scrapbook. Collecting snippets, photos, articles, jo bhi milta hai about Michael Jackson, sab jama karo. Wahi cheez, that same propensity, that same thing, Prabhupada is saying, do it for Krishna. That is manmana. Surround yourself with Krishna. Wherever you look in any corner of your house, all the walls which are filled with paintings of abstract art, of beautiful scenery, you want to keep them, keep them. But wherever there is space left, fill it with Krishna. Fill it with images of whoever is your Ishta Devta, Radha Gopinath, Radha Giridhari, Radha Ras Bihari, Radha Kunj Bihari, Radha Madan Mohan, whoever is your Ishta Devta. Put a nice, beautiful picture. Right? Your laptop screensaver, put a picture of Krishna. Your phone, your eternal companion, right? fill that also with Krishna. Everywhere, you know, you can think of, put Krishna there. Give the altar, you know, most houses, and this is true for most people, most houses, the altar is tucked away in some remote corner of the house or the kitchen. Ek chota sa dabba banaya rehta hai. Wo dabbe ke andar chota sa, you know, alag alag. It's like a supermarket of all deities. Aise mat karo. Try to have a nice, beautiful altar in your house. Give the Supreme Lord the prominence he deserves. He is in your life providing everything you want. Everything you need is provided by Krishna. We have already discussed in various verses of the Gita, Krishna has said, I am providing you everything. Give him the prominence he deserves. Not that he demands, he's not asking for it. But we, out of our our sheer gratitude. We don't have any love for Krishna. Out of sheer gratitude, my Lord, you have given me everything. Everything I have is coming from you. Give him that altar. Create a beautiful altar. Learn from other devotees ki altar kaise banane ka hota hai. Right? We have created this, you know, this system, this devotee care system in Radha Gopinath temple. There is a mentor system. Our Rajshekhar Prabhu, Remuna Prabhu, he is a designated mentor created by Radha Gopinath temple, given that service by Radha Gopinath temple to mentor devotees jo naye naye bhakti mein aaye hain, to bring them up to a point and, you know, train them intensely. What are the practical things that one can do in bhakti? Become part of that mentor system. Go join it. Go there. Go through that training for 2-3 years, whatever time it takes. Do it. Don't sit on the sidelines ki main na khali lecture attend karunga, mera ho gaya. No. Take that training. Take that step. Take that commitment for Krishna. Not for yourself. Not for pleasing anybody. Whether you like it, don't like it, comfortable, not comfortable, take the step. Prominent space in the house. Keep all the books of Srila Prabhupada in your home. For those of you who do not have Srimad Bhagavatam, do not have Bhagavad, those who have mostly Bhagavad Gita as it is, everyone has. Mostly everybody has. But Bhagavatam, not everybody has. I don't know of the people who are on this call right now, how many? There are 40 people there on this call other than me. So there's 39 people on this call. Is there anyone on this call who does not have Srimad Bhagavatam, does not have Nectar of Devotion, does not have Chaitanya Charitamrit in their homes? Please raise hand. There is a facility to raise hand somewhere in this. I don't know. Ramana Prabhu, are you able to see it?
No, raise hands ka nahi hai.
Nahi hai kya?
No, it's there and more. You have, more
mein. You have to go into participant. You have to go into participant and you can raise hand there. Like Vandana Juchi Mataji has raised her hand. Okay, just now. So click on participants. You will see your name right on top. There you have an opportunity. You can raise your hand. So those of you right now, I'll request you. Those of you who do not have either Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrit, Nectar of Devotion, any of these books, or Krishna book, these five books, I will say. If you don't have these books at home, please go and raise your hand over there. Okay. So it is my, and all 40 of us can do this. If you don't have it, do it. Just raise it. It'll take you like 5 seconds to do it. But it is an opportunity for us to state that, okay, I don't have, then somebody can reach out to you and can request you to buy these books, right? So the first step is having these books in your house. They're so important. Bhagavad Gita is so important. Bhagavatam is so important. You know, if all of us can understand the importance of these scriptures, ki ye kitna valuable hai. Hame uska andaza bhi nahi hai. Ye Bhagavatam kitna important hai, kitna valuable hai. You know, there's this story that's always told in book distribution marathon. Every year they tell this story that there was this man whose father was about to die. Okay, he was living in a colony and his father was about to die. So someone came and told him, "Arey, Bhagavad Gita padho unko. Read the important verses, second chapter, Bhagavad Gita padho." So he said, "Mere paas Gita nahi hai." आपके पास गीता नहीं है? नहीं, गीता नहीं है. तो अच्छा ठीक है, तो जरा नेबर्स को जाके पूछो. He went to the neighbor's house. Nobody has गीता. He went to 10, 15, 20, 30, 50 flats. Nobody in the colony had a Bhagavad Gita. Finally, he saw one door open. It was a Christian. With a great shame on his face, he went and, this is a true story. With great shame on his face, he went and asked, "By any chance, uncle, would you have a Bhagavad Gita?" He said, "Matter of fact, I do. Somebody sold it to me at the railway station. I felt tempted and I bought it. I have it. Take it." So he took the Bhagavad Gita. He went and he read it to his father, dying father. Father left his body. So let us not have that situation in our lives. Bhagavad Gita is not a scripture that we read only at the time of death. You know, sometimes I remember a few weeks back, our Jadekar Prabhu had sent this cartoon, you know, this animation showing that too young to read Krishna, too busy to read Krishna, too young to read Gita, too busy to read Gita, too much in love to read Gita, and too old to read Gita, and now too late to read Gita. You know, let's not make our life like that. So all of you, those who don't have, those of you who have raised your hands, Remuna Prabhu or Sachin Prabhu, if you're on the call, please make a note, whoever it is. And we can reach out to these devotees and request them. If they are inspired, let them buy these books, you know, and keep them in your house. Don't just keep them. Bhagavad Gita, Zashi Ahe Tashi. No. Pick them up, read them. Read all of Srila Prabhupada's books. Listen to Harikatha. This is Harikatha. Bhagavad Gita is Harikatha. Srimad Bhagavatam is Harikatha. Listen to this as a regulative principle. Not that, you know, kabhi apun ko aaj bahut mood hua yaar Harikatha sunne ka. Chalo aaj Harikatha ho jaye. No. It has to become a habit. It has to become a part of our life as a regulative principle. Decide a fixed schedule for hearing. That every Sunday morning Bhagavatam, I will listen. Or every Sunday evening HPCL class, I will join and I will listen. I will prioritize this. I will not keep anything else on Sunday evenings. Sunday evening matlab apna lecture hai bhai. Apne ko ye rakhne ka. Jab tak ye chal raha hai, tab tak chalne do. Till when we are continuing like this. See, we have come to the end of Bhagavad Gita. There's a possibility we may end also. We may not continue beyond the end of Gita. So abhi jitna hai, le lo. Don't miss. Online lectures are available all over the world. All over the world. So many wonderful speakers are now conducting lectures online. Kisi ko bhi pakad lo aur chipak jao. Regulative principle. Associate with and form deep friendships with senior devotees as well as equals. Not just, don't have relationship only with those who are junior to you in bhakti. Hey, so they will all be like, oh, Prabhuji, you are so wonderful. You are such a great devotee. They'll always be glorifying you, those who are junior to you. Those who are senior to you, you know, you are always worshipping them, but itna kuch wo hai nahi. It is your equals who will tell you, Prabhu, kaha ho, aajkal aate hi nahi ho satsang mein, kaha hai, kya chal raha hai, itna kya busy ho gaye, aa jao. So somebody will catch your ears and bring you here. So we need association, take association. Surround yourself with these things, with images, with screensavers, with altars, with books of Prabhupada, with Harikatha, with association of devotees. Surround yourself with these things, right? Then you cannot but think of Krishna. Start your day, you know, when we start our day, how to think of Krishna? How I can practically, right? What is the lifestyle of a Vaishnava? Some of us may be wondering, many of us are already following this lifestyle, maybe not so consistently, maybe not on a regular basis, maybe not with so much purity. We may be doing it as a ritual. Never mind. Never mind. Just keep doing it. Keep associating with you. Keep hearing. If you hear, that ritual will become spiritual. If we don't hear, Harikatha regularly, even the spiritual activity will become ritual. The spirit will be gone, it will become a ritual. Keep associating. So, what are the practical activities that I can do on a day-to-day basis so that I can do these four things? Man mana, bhava madbhakto, madhyaji, man namaskuru. What are the practical activities? So, I will just share some thoughts and I will welcome towards the end anybody wants to contribute. What else can be done to always remember Krishna? And there are a million things, believe me. There is no limit. If you want to remember Krishna, sarvasya chaham ridhi sanivishto matta smritir jnanam apohanam. So memory as well as forgetfulness and all knowledge are provided by the super soul. Krishna residing in the heart is giving us that. So if you want to forget Krishna, I don't want Krishna in my life. He will give you all apohanam, all forget from samne se devotee aaye to bhi aapko nazar nahi aayega. Aap dekhoge lekin aapko wo strike hi nahi hoga ki are ye to Hare Krishna wale hai, main pehle ye karta tha. You will not even remember. You want to forget Krishna, Krishna will help you to forget. You want to remember Krishna, he will help you to remember, right? So let us discuss. So start your day when you get up in the morning. Start your day with a small prayer to Krishna. You know, like sometimes what devotees do is they chant the Pranati mantra of their guru. If you are not initiated, then you can start with Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namane Namaste Saraswati Deve Gaurvani Pracharane Nirvishesh Nivadi Paschat Deshtarne Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaur Bhaktivinoda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare. You can chant the holy names of the Lord. If you have a phone, you have a tendency, the moment subah utte hi pehla phone hath mein aata hai. So phone dekho, phone pe bhi aapko Bhagwan hi dikhai denge. You have already put screen saver Bhagwan. You will see Dada Gopinath's beautiful darshan first thing in the morning. Sometimes exclamation mein aata hai, Shri Krishna Govinda Narayana Vasudeva Hari, whatever names of the Lord come to your mouth, let them come. Start with Mam Namaskuru. Start the day by paying obeisances to the Lord. In form of prayer, in form of devotees sometimes pay proper obeisances. They get down from the bed and offer obeisances. If you can do that, very good. If you remember, very good. Otherwise, at least remember Krishna in the morning. Then, you know, many years back, my counselor, His Grace Muralidhar Prabhu, he had told me that, you know, devotees ko chanting karne bolo, to wo log karte hain. Devotees are able to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra 16 rounds every day. They do for 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, 50 years, they're able to do. But tell them to read Srimad Bhagavatam. Tell them to read Bhagavad Gita. To unko nahi hota hai. Not that they don't want to read. It's not that mera intention hi nahi hai padhne ka. Nahi, aisa nahi hai. I just don't get round to doing it. So he had given a very good, what is called in today's world, a hack. Right? In today's world, if somebody gives you a practical idea, it's called a hack. So he had given a wonderful hack. He said, rather than saying, mera pura din khatam hone ke baad, end of day's play, I will read Krishna book, I'll read Bhagavatam, I'll read Bhagavad Gita. By that time, you're already so tired. Moment you pick up Bhagavad Gita, like, you know, aap aisa bhari ho jata hai. You'll immediately start falling asleep. You know, His Grace Radha Gopinath Prabhu sometimes joking, he says, the best, you know, what is that? For insomniacs, is the best cure. Pick up Bhagavatam and start reading. Within 10 minutes, you will fall asleep. Right? Why? Because we are already mentally too tired. We are not fresh. What is the mind we want to offer? Man manha. And I want to offer my mind to Krishna in what way? When it is fresh. So what Muralidhar Prabhu was suggesting was, he was saying, in the morning, if possible, for 10-15 minutes, first you read. Read Bhagavatam, read Gita, read Chaitanya Charitamrita, read whatever you want. Read any of the scriptures, okay? But read in the morning, early morning, as soon as you get up, for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, you can read. Like, you know, now our Yugavatar Prabhu, one of the senior devotees in our temple, he's also a doctor, he's also a counselor, he's also a very talented devotee, he writes very well. So this person, he has created a WhatsApp group, okay? Where every day morning, he sends one verse from Bhagavatam. Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya. So it's every day. So like on from the 1st to the 10th of the month, he sends 1st canto, 2nd canto, 3rd canto, 4th canto, like that till the 10th canto, 1st to 10th of the month. Then again, 11th to 20th of the month, again 1st canto, 2nd canto. So one verse from each canto every day. Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya. Then there is another WhatsApp group in which he sends Bhagavad Gita daily. So it's called Bhagavad Gita in a year. So there are 365 days in a year. There are some 700 verses in Bhagavad Gita. So in 1 year, full Bhagavad Gita reading ho jata. Full. He sends one verse, sometimes two verses. So he nicely times it in such a way that Jan to December, aapka pura Bhagavad Gita padke ho jata. Right? Then he also has a third group in which he sends a small passage from Krishna book, a small passage from Mahabharata. Roj ye padhne mein hi 10-15 minute ho hi jata hai, every day. And isi ke bahane apna nityam bhagavat sevaya bhi ho jata hai, nityam gita sevaya bhi ho jata hai. I would strongly recommend, whoever is interested, please reach out to me. I will add all of you to that group. Or I will send the invite for that group to you individually and you can join that group. उसी बहाने एवरी डे इन द मॉर्निंग एटलीस्ट वी एंड अप रीडिंग भगवत गीता श्रीमद भागवतम कृष्णा बुक. These are the books that Srila Prabhupada spent his entire life writing. So much effort he has put in writing these books. It is our bounden duty, and it is our means of thinking of Krishna. When you're reading about Krishna, you're thinking about. And the Bhagavad Gita, the Srimad Bhagavatam is non-different than Krishna. It is like you're associating with Krishna. When we read the Bhagavad Gita, when we hear it, when we hear Srimad Bhagavatam, when we read it, we are associating with Krishna. Have that faith. This is what the Acharyas have told us. They are not lying to us. It's a fact. Then, after you're finished reading for the 10-15 minutes, then sit down to chant the holy names. Chant with enthusiasm. Manas trayate iti mantra. And this is Maha Mantra. Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Eva Kevalam, Kalau Na Astiva, Na Astiva, Na Astiva, Gatir Anyata. This Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Chant with enthusiasm. Chant like you mean it. What are we chanting? When we chant, what is the meaning of that holy name? It is, O all attractive Krishna, O energy of the Lord Hare, O reservoir of all pleasure, Lord Ram, please engage me in your service. Now, when you are praying like this, when you are begging to the Lord, my Lord, I beg you, please engage me in your service. Chant like you mean it. Chant with that desperation. Chant with that enthusiasm like you mean it. Don't just get through your rounds staring into infinity. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Bro, किसी को सुनाई नहीं देता है, किसी को पता भी नहीं चलता है. Even super soul in your heart can practically barely hear what you are chanting. That is not chanting. Chant with enthusiasm. Chant like you mean it. After you have completed your rounds, do your aarti. That is madhyaji, worshipping the deities in your home, right? If time permits, whoever has time. This is not for everybody. But whoever is retired, or maybe those who are at home, you know, who are maybe homemakers, if you have the time, listen to Srimad Bhagavatam class daily. Every day in our temple, Bhagavatam classes is chanted. Today only Gaurang Prabhu mentioned that in 1993, they started the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. And today in December 2020, we have reached the 12th canto, 10th chapter. The last few chapters of Bhagavatam are remaining now. It will probably get completed in the next couple of months, right? For so many years in Shishi Radha Gopinath temple, every day the Srimad Bhagavatam is read, studied, and you know, discussed every day. And it is broadcasted free, live, over a YouTube channel. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, listen to it. चलो रोज नहीं सुनते. मैं तो आई गो टू ऑफिस प्रभु जी एट दैट टाइम 8 o'clock आई एम गोइंग टू ऑफिस आई कांट हियर. अपने गाड़ी में कम्यूट के टाइम सुनो. जस्ट पुट इट ऑन स्पीकर एंड लिसन इफ यू कैन इफ यू हैव टाइम व्हाइल गोइंग कमिंग यू कैन हियर हरि कथा राइट. इफ यू कैनॉट हियर डेली एटलीस्ट हियर ऑन वीकेंड्स ऑन सैटरडेज ऑन संडेज. Special, some of the senior devotees typically speak on Saturdays and Sundays. Listen on those days. Why leave it? Kyun chhodna hai ye opportunity? It is such a benediction to listen to these devotees who have scrutinizingly studied the scriptures and are presenting it to us in a palatable manner. What a benediction. Mat chhodo ye benediction. Ye blessing aapko roj fukat mein mil raha hai. उसीलिए हम इसको चीपली लेते हैं. वी टेक इट चीपली बिकॉज इट्स अवेलेबल सो इजीली. ओ इट इज द ग्रेटेस्ट ब्लेसिंग इन ऑल क्रिएशन. देयर इज नो गिफ्ट ग्रेटर देन द भागवतम. हैव फेथ एंड लिसन. ओके नाउ यू स्टार्टेड योर डे यू नो यू पेड ऑबेसेंस टू द लॉर्ड यू रेड अ फ्यू वर्सेस यू चैंटेड यू डिड योर आरती फॉर द डीटीज. इफ यू हैव डीटीज डू आरती. इफ यू डोंट हैव डीटीज कीप अ पिक्चर ऑफ डीटीज एंड वर्शिप देम एवरी डे इन द मॉर्निंग राइट. Then if time permits, you heard Bhagavatam class. Now your day starts. Your day starts. Now if you're working in an office, what can you do? Prabhupada says, work for Krishna. See Krishna as your super boss. तुम्हारा boss कोई भी होगा, आपका boss कोई भी होगा, लेकिन आपका super boss कौन है? Super boss is the supreme personality of Godhead Krishna. Work dedicatedly for his pleasure. Evaluate at all times. Be conscious. What will please the Lord and what will not please him? This is Krishna consciousness. International Society for Krishna Consciousness. Being conscious of Krishna means what? All times, man mana. Thinking of Krishna at all times that, oh, I'm doing this. This will not be pleasing to the Lord. I should not do this. Mam anusmara yudhyacha tasmat sarveshu kaleshu. Mam anusmara yudhyacha 8.7 Krishna is saying. Therefore, always thinking of me, Prabhupada says, in my form of Krishna. There also he says, thinking of me in my form of Krishna, do your duty. Yudhyacha. Mam anusmara yudhyacha. Right? So like that. Dedicatedly work for the pleasure of the Lord. Keep images of Krishna in your office, in your workspace, in your kitchen. If you're working in your kitchen, you're working in your room, wherever you're working, keep images of Krishna so that at least beech beech mein Bhagwan ka darshan hote rahega. You will remember, main kiske liye kar raha hun? Main itna jo ghis maar raha hun, itna jo main mehnat kar raha hun, main kiske liye kar raha hun? I'm not doing it for my wife. I'm not doing it for my kids. I'm not doing it for my bank balance. I want to. I may not be doing it, but I at least intend to. I at least aspire to do this for you, Krishna. So therefore, keep Krishna in your vicinity. If you are working on a job which is mundane and repetitive in nature, and if you are allowed in your office, have some light kirtan also going. If you have a elaborate job which requires your intelligence and your full attention, please do not do this. Do not put kirtan, do not put any lecture during working time. Don't do it. Only if you have a very repetitive job, jisme koi matlab, you don't really apply your intelligence and you are allowed to a lot of people listen to music anyway. Why not you put little soft kirtan? Don't make everybody in the office hear it. Aapke liye, soft kirtan, right? If possible, for the Matajis who are at home, who are homemakers, while you're cooking, while you're cleaning the home, listen to Harikatha. Rather than listening to so many mundane Gramya Katha of this world, which will not do anything for you. It will only increase your desires. It will only increase your agitation. It will only increase your anxiety in this world. It will only keep giving you more and more ideas for sense gratification. Ye sab sunne se acha hari katha suno. You will be in good consciousness. Even the cooking that you do will be done in excellent consciousness. You'll be doing it for Krishna. You will keep being reminded, arey, I'm doing this for Krishna. Like that, right? So now you are working for Krishna, whether you're working in an office, you're working in a business, you're working in a sports environment, you're working in a home, whatever you're doing, you're trying to Krishnaize your activities by working for Krishna. You're trying to Krishnaize your environment by keeping beautiful pictures of whoever is your Ishtadev. Unka rakho, Radha Gopinath, Radha Kunj Bihari, jo bhi hai, unka ek image aapke work desk pe rakho, taki kaam karte samay aapko Bhagwan nazar aaye. Right? Then, after you have done all your work, what happens? You get the fruits of your work. Offer the fruits of what you receive first to Krishna. This is again part of Madhyaji, worshipping Krishna. With what I can worship Krishna? Everything belongs to Krishna. What I have earned, what money I have earned, what fruits I have got, it's all coming by Krishna's mercy only. But if I take those fruits and I offer it to Krishna first, that is very pleasing to the Lord. So offer the fruits of what you receive first to Krishna. Give in charity. Every year during Janmashtami, we approach so many devotees that would you like to know our temple, Radha Gopinath temple, for example, we approach devotees during Janmashtami for donations. Those donations, they fund all the activities that are happening in the temple, whether they are worshipping of deities, all the different offerings that are made to the Lord, the dresses that are made for the Lord, the prasad that is distributed in the temple, the food for life that is done, everything is coming out of donations that devotees make. Donate to the Lord. Give in charity. That is anyway the duty of all grihasthas. Donate to the Lord. Then you will not feel too much, you know, pride. Because when we give, we realize that what I'm giving, I am earning, you know, 2 lakhs per month, and I am giving some 5,000 or 10,000 rupees once in a year. Aray, what that is? It's not even pinching you. Kuch farak bhi nahi pad raha. Chalega. Jitna dena hai, utna do. But give to Krishna. Right? Give in charity. Serve in your congregation. Your congregation needs your service. Offer your skills to your congregation. You are a good singer, do kirtan. You are a good instrument player, play instruments in kirtan. You are good in serving Vaishnavas, go and stand in the prasad serving queue that I want to serve. Offer your service. Then, offer whatever you have first to Krishna and then use it. So when we eat food, first we offer to the Lord. Patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhakta prayachati tad aham bhakti upartam ashnami prayatatmana. Krishna says, if you offer me with love and devotion, a fruit, a flower, a leaf, or water, I will accept it. Krishna very lovingly accepts whatever we give him. If we offer with love, twice in that verse, bhakti comes. With bhakti, if you offer to Krishna, Krishna is forced to accept. He can't say no. He takes it. Offer whatever you have got for yourself. You may have brought it. See, when we buy things, when we make things, we don't think of Krishna. We think of our own enjoyment. अरे यार क्या मस्त कपड़े, ये कपड़े खरीद के मैं कितना अच्छा लगूंगा, I look so nice. Wearing this nice, you know, nice perfume, I will smell so nice. Fine. But before you enjoy it, first offer it to the Lord. Whether it is food, whether it is clothes, whether it is some cosmetic, it is perfume, whether it is a car, whether it is a new laptop, whether it is anything new. Whatever new, as long as it is appropriate to offer to the Lord and practical to offer to the Lord, please offer. This is Madhyaji. This is worshipping the Lord. Take out time. Take out time to preach the message of the Lord. And you may say, I am not a preacher. Prabhuji, mere ko kidhar aata hai Bhagavad Gita? Mere ko kidhar aata hai Bhagavatam? Humko thodi itna sab bolne ko aata hai. Humko thodi Bhagwan ne aisa प्रीच करने का ऐसा वो लैंग्वेज अपने को दिया नहीं है. डजंट मैटर. प्रीच इन व्हाटएवर स्मॉल वे यू कैन. यू कैन ऑलवेज गो टू योर रिलेटिव्स, टू योर फ्रेंड्स, टू योर नेबर्स, टू योर कलीग्स एंड टेल देम दैट यू नो आई डोंट नो इफ यू हैव नोटिस्ड, आई हैव बीन गोइंग टू दिस इस्कॉन फॉर लास्ट 2-3 years. इट हैज रियली चेंज्ड माय लाइफ. आई फील सो हैप्पी नाउ. आई फील सो सैटिस्फाइड. यू नो इट इज रियली हेल्पिंग मी. इतना भी बोल दिया, ये भी प्रीचिंग हुआ. यू आर ट्राइंग टू एडवर्टाइज कृष्णा एंड कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस टू द वर्ल्ड. टेक आउट टाइम टू प्रीच. टेक आउट टाइम टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द बुक्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड. वॉट एवर बुक्स, श्रीमद भागवतम, भगवद गीता, वॉट एवर दी स्क्रिप्चर्स आर देयर, टेक आउट टाइम टू रीड देम. टेक आउट टाइम टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट देम. यू नो नाउ दिस मंथ इज अ मंथ ऑफ बुक मैराथन. इन दिस मंथ, if we can participate in this service of giving Krishna to others, how we can participate? Either that I will go house to house and I will distribute these Bhagavad Gitas. I can't do that. Okay, if someone asks me, I will distribute Bhagavad Gita. Or I'll just call up people and say, hey, you know, this is the month of Gita Jayanti. This is the month in which Bhagavad Gita was spoken by Krishna to Arjuna. So in this month, on behalf of ISKCON, we distribute these books based on Bhagavad Gita or the Srimad Bhagavatam to all people at a discounted price so that people will take it, read it, and transform their lives. Would you like to take a look at these books? Right? Try it. It doesn't cost you anything. Kya hoga? Jada se jada koi na bol dega. Your ego will be hurt. Very good. If our ego is crushed, that's a good thing. If our pride is crushed, that's a good thing. We will progress in bhakti. Perform some fixed service for Krishna. The key word is fixed. Fix yourself in some service. Just see, our this program that is going on all the way since 1998. I think 1998 to 2006, continuously for 8 years it went on. That time it was our Smita Krishna Prabhu, you know. He was running the program. In 2010, it started. Now in 2020, 10 years it has been going on. Why? Because one person took it on himself. Remuna Prabhu said that ye program hona hai. He pulled me into it. And this program has been going on. It's a fixed service. It's a fixed service. Every Sunday, behind the scenes, he calls me. He asks me, Prabhuji, are you available this Sunday? Okay, which verse you're going to take? From where you're going to do? It's a fixed service. Then, when we used to have physical program, there were devotees who would come before the program, set up the altar. They would set up the altar. They would put a cloth on that table. They would put the deities. They would put the picture. They would put garland. Somebody would buy the garland every time. Huh? Our Brahmankar Prabhu would buy the garlands. Our Koit Prabhu, Remuna Prabhu would set up the altar. Sachin Prabhu would set up the altar. Every week, every fortnight, whenever we were having it, every fortnight. Then after the program is over, prasadam distribution, there's a set of devotees who do it. After prasadam distribution is over, there are devotees who do the wind-up of the program. Fixed service. Pick up fixed service. When we pick up fixed service, sometimes you have to stretch ourselves. Stretch yourself for Krishna. The best way to become fixed up in bhakti is to pick up a fixed service. Whatever service, however menial, however insignificant, doesn't matter. If we do service for the Lord, we make progress. We become committed to bhakti. Otherwise, apne liye it is like a hobby. Arey, kya mast hai yaar, maza aata hai apne ko lecture sunne ko. No, that is good, but it's not good enough. That's not what Krishna is saying here. Man mana means think of me alone. Do kirtan in the evening if possible. Read scripture. Okay, now the day is getting over. You have done your work. I'm sorry, I'm going a little over time, but I'll try and end as quickly as possible, right? So, because it's an important verse, so my apologies for if I go a little bit over time. I'll try to end as soon as possible. So, now the day is over. You have finished your work. Ladies have done the housework. They have done their office work. Men have done office work and hopefully housework as well. Sab ho gaya, din khatam, aapne kuch seva bhi kar liya, book distribution kiya, kuch prachar kiya, jo bhi kiya. Now, in the evening, if you have time, if you feel like the whole month of Damodar, you're all doing kirtan in the evenings. Very beautiful, very inspiring, very, very pleasing to the heart. Everyone likes to do kirtan, right? To take part in bhajan. Wonderful, make it a habit. Doesn't have to be only in Kartik, do it full year. Kaun roka hai? Kisne aapko bola hai? Sirf Kartik mein hi karna hai. No, you can do it all through the year. Right? Then, before you sleep, try to chant or try to read scripture. Prabhupada said that reading Krishna, a lot of devotees said, reading Krishna book before you sleep is very pleasing. You get nice dreams also. You feel very nice by reading Krishna book. Right? Then, for those who want to go to the next level of commitment, you're doing all of this activity. These are all manmana, bhava, mad bhakto, madhyaji, mam, namaskuru. All these activities we discuss from morning to night, we have discussed. Those who want to take the commitment to the next level, welcome deities into your house. We saw, you know, all these days in Damodar Ashtakam, those who had deities in the house, like our Sachin Prabhu, our Remuna Prabhu, you know, whoever, our, whichever devotees had deities in the home. It's a very special thing. Having a picture of the Lord is very beautiful, very nice. But deities ho, uska ek alag level hota hai. Simple Laddu Gopal, Gaur Nitai, Jagannath, Baldev Subhadra, whatever you are inspired, take guidance. Don't do it just without guidance. Take guidance from a devotee and then do it. Once they are in your home, treat them like they are the owners of the house. Is ghar ka malik kon hai? Mai hai? No. Gaur Nitai hai. Jagannath Baldev Subhadra hai. They are the owners of the house. Make them the substance, soul and center point of your house. Or koi nahi, they are the center. And serve them also like that. Don't just say that, oh, they are the center. They are the owners of this house. No. Serve them like that. Offer nice bhoga. serve them nicely, give them bath, do whatever you can. Then visit the temple weekly, visit holy dhams whenever possible, whenever opportunity comes up. Do these things. The process of bhakti is very scientific and is transcendental at the same time. So aisa hai that the holy names, if we chant the holy names, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. We chant the holy names sincerely, regularly, with intensity. From the holy name, the form of the Lord will be revealed. This is described by the Acharyas. Acharyas have experienced this. From the form, then the qualities of the Lord will be revealed. Then the pastimes of the Lord will be revealed. Within our mind, we will be able to see Krishna. This is the promise. This is, and this is liberation. If you are able to see Krishna in this self same body, you are already liberated. It is possible. We may not be at that level. We may not have faith. We need to have faith in the words of the Acharyas that this is possible. The process gradually purifies us. You may feel, I am not at that level. Guruji, aap kya ye bol rahe? What ye exotic, esoteric bol rahe? Ye to nahi ho sakta hai mere se. But Prabhu, if we have faith, Prabhuji and Mataji, if we have faith, it is possible. The process has been described. Adho shraddha tata sadhu sangha tata bhajana kriya. Anartha nivritti syad nishtha ruchi asakti. You know, bhava, prema. These are the processes. It starts with adho shraddha, little faith. Then we do sadhu sangha. Then we come in sadhu sangha, we do bhajan kriya. After a lot of sadhu sangha and bhajan kriya, then anartha nivritti, all the lust, anger, greed, envy, pride, illusion in our heart is all eliminated. Then we get full faith. Are yaar, this process works. It becomes nishtha, hard faith, unshakable faith, nishtha. After nishtha comes ruchi, then we start getting taste. In the same activities that earlier we were doing as a ritual, now taste comes. We chant holy name, we can feel Krishna and the holy name. When we read Bhagavatam, we can experience Krishna. When we worship deities, we can experience the body. You can see that this is Krishna. This is not some, you know, some doll or some idol made out of metal or wood or whatever. We can experience Krishna. Taste, ruchi. And from that ruchi comes asakti. Asakti means what? Attachment. Now I get attached to the Lord. Then comes bhava, emotions, strong emotions. And finally comes prema bhakti, pure unalloyed love for God. So we are not pure devotees. We are not on that level. But stay in the process. Just stay committed. Just keep doing what you are doing. And take association of devotees. You will get there. You will get there. What is the promise that the Lord is making for one who lives like this? One who's living this life, he says, you will come to me. I promise you, you will come to me. Now the Acharyas explain that Arjuna may ask, are these Mathura people, they keep making vows. Bada bada vows karte rehte. So Krishna says, I am making a solemn vow. I am making a solemn vow. And why? I am also saying that because you are my devotee, you are dear to me. He says that, priyosi me. Because you are dear to me, therefore no one cheats a person who is dear, no? So please believe my promise. And I am saying, believe. So Acharya is explaining like that. So anyone who is in such pure Krishna consciousness, who lives this life, what we just discussed, none of this is kuch bahut exotic nahi hai, ye simple hai. Karne ke liye bahut simple hai. But karne ki ichha, karne ki niyat honi chahiye. We should have the desire, we should have that sincerity, that determination that I want to do it. Okay, I may not enjoy it because I am still in adho shraddha stage. I don't enjoy it. I don't have ruchi. But I have faith in the words of the Acharya, so I will do it. If we do it, what is the gift Krishna is saying? Anyone who is in such pure Krishna consciousness will surely return to the abode of Krishna, Goloka Vrindavan, the highest planet in the spiritual world where the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna resides. We will get residence there. And what will we do there? To engage in the association of Krishna face to face. These are the words that the Acharyas are using, Prabhupada is using. To engage in the association of Krishna face to face in a spiritual body. What does that mean? What does liberation from this body mean? What does liberation from the material world mean? What does going to the spiritual world mean? It means no more anxiety, Vaikuntha. No more anxiety, no more competition. So much competition in this world. No more competition. No more fights between husband and wife, between enemies. No more fights. No more China, India, Pakistan, nothing. No more frustration. No more burning anger, envy, pride, lust, illusion. All these things are burning in our heart. No more. Gone. Khatam. Chali gache. But what is going to remain? A genuine and eternally increasing loving relationship with the most loving and compassionate person in this entire creation, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, and in the association of like-minded pure devotees. This is what we will get if we go to the spiritual world, a life, eternal life, full of bliss and full of knowledge. The eternal constitutional nature of the soul will be attained if we live this life. Can we attain the same perfection as what Krishna is telling Arjuna? Prabhupada says, anyone who follows the path of Arjuna can become a dear friend to Krishna and obtain the same perfection. Prabhupada says in the purport very clearly, don't divert to even other expansions of Krishna. Not Vishnu, not Narayan, not Ram, not Varahadev, not Narsingham, nothing. Meditate on the form of Krishna. Like Arjuna, Prabhupada said, we should also concentrate our mind upon Krishna, the very form with two hands, carrying a flute, the bluish boy with a beautiful face and peacock feather in his hair. That form of Shyam Sundar Krishna we should meditate on. Concentration of the mind on this form of Krishna constitutes the most confidential part of all knowledge. And this is disclosed to Arjuna. Why? Because he is the most dear friend of Krishna. And because we are so very, very, very fortunate. Hamara koi aukat nahi hai, koi deserving nahi hai hum log. Simply because we are connected to ISKCON, to Srila Prabhupada and the followers of Srila Prabhupada. Therefore, this confidential knowledge is available to you and me also. Let us make our life perfect. Let us at least attempt to make our life perfect by trying to follow the instructions that are given by our acharyas on the instructions of the Supreme Lord. And in this lifetime itself, this promise that Krishna is giving is available to us if we are sincere. I thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Srila Gurudev ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanandi, Hari Hari Bol. Hare Krishna. Sorry for going over time. I will ask if anyone has any questions or comments. Please go ahead. Hare Krishna. Any questions or comments, anybody?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Dandat Pranam.
Yes, Mataji.
Prabhuji, really means very useful tips you have given for, means practical tips, what in a full day, what anyone can do. And thank you so much, Prabhuji. Good, I attended today's lecture, otherwise I would have missed it. Thank you, Prabhuji. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Mataji. You are already following all of this and more. Thank you. Thank you for encouraging me.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thanks a lot.
Anybody else?
Yeah, Prabhuji, can I?
Yes, Prabhu.
You know, the 65 verse that you have so beautifully explained with all the commensurate practical tips to be following the Krishna consciousness. I've got a small, you know, we have Chatushloki Bhagavati, 10.8, 10.9, 10.10, 10.10, 10.11. If this, the 18.65 is the essence, how come those are the Chatushloki Bhagavati?
Acha, you're asking that why does Chatushloki Bhagavad Gita exist as it is like that?
What I understood from today's lecture of yours is this 65 is the essence, 65 yeah. And 66, yeah. Right? Yeah. And then are these not the Chaturshloki Bhagavati? Are these not the essence? Because that's why, you know, we are calling them Chaturshloki.
Okay, good question. Yeah, even that is, see, the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna keeps giving, he keeps sprinkling, you know, from time to time and place to place. He keeps sprinkling drops of nectar. Okay. So in the 10th chapter, Arjuna is again asked, can you please tell me about your opulences, right? So then Krishna says, okay, if you want, I will again tell you. And there he speaks, you know, these verses. And there are many verses. Chaturshloki we say because these four are very, very important verses. Very, very important. And they give the, you know, the summary of the, you know, of Krishna's position, right? If we can just go there for a moment. Let's just do it 1 second. While we're at it. So, chapter 10. Yeah. So, text 8, text 9, text 10, text 11, right? Text 8. I am the source of all spiritual and material worlds. Everything emanates from me. The wise who perfectly know this, engage in my devotion service and worship with all their hearts. So, Krishna is telling his position. Then he speaks about the relationship with the devotee. The thoughts of my pure devotees dwell in me. Their lives are fully devoted in my service. And they derive great satisfaction and bliss from always enlightening one another and conversing about me, right? So he's speaking about the reciprocation that his pure devotees have with me, who is the source of all spiritual and material worlds, right? So he has already said, know this and engage in my devotional service. So next verse, he talks about what is this devotional service. Then text 10, he talks about what is the result of engaging in devotional service. Those who are constantly devoted to me, to serving me with love, I give the understanding by which they can come to me. And then text 11, he says, to show them special mercy, I dwelling in the heart, destroy with the shining lamp of knowledge the darkness born of ignorance. So if you see, in these four verses also, Krishna has kind of summarized everything. Who is he? How can he be attained by devotional service? A devotional service ka paribhasha kya hai? What is the meaning of this devotional service? And what is the benefit of this devotional service? So in one sense, it summarizes the Gita. That's why it is called Chaturshloki. But here in 18.64.65, he himself is saying ki this is the essence. So therefore, we accept this.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Right. Thank you. My, one small, one of my colleagues, my friends, Arvind Agarwal from Kota is attending today. For the first time he has come. So
thank you for inviting your friends. Last time also you had invited 2 or 3 people. Yeah. Today also invited. Yeah. Thank you. This is a wonderful service you're doing. And I'm very grateful to your friends for joining and participating in this. And I hope to see them again next time. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Anybody else? Any other questions, comments, or shall we end here? All right. So if there's no further questions or comments, I will hand over to our Brahme Prabhu. Just one last thing I want to say before we go. We are in the midst of the book distribution marathon. This year, everything is happening virtually. I will humbly request once more, those of you who have raised your hands, thank you for being so honest and, you know, coming up with this. Those who don't have Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, or any of these books, Nectar of Devotion, Krishna book, if you don't have these books, please send a message. I'm sure Sachin Prabhu is there on this call. I don't know if he's there.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandavat.
You're there, huh? So if you have noted down who are the people, Prabhuji, you can reach out to them. And, you know, y'all can just please give him which books you want. This year, they have actually organized for home delivery, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Home delivery also something they have done, some jugaad for that. Because minimum touch, you know. So the temple is doing everything it can to keep the flame, you know, alive. We request you to participate by yourself buying books, which you don't have. And also distributing books to your friends, your relatives, because the greatest gift you can give anybody is give them Krishna. And Krishna is available through his books, Hare Krishna. Sorry, back to you, Brahme Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Another master class, I must.